After starting this module, you shall be able to know about the International Standard Industrial Classification of All Economic Activities ISIC and the National Industrial Classification NIC of India. Learn about the genesis and the subsequent changes that have taken place in ISIC and NIC over the years to meet the international and national requirements. Identify the difference and advancement made during each revision of ISIC and NIC. Understand the details and the difference in structure of the ISIC and NIC. Classification of industries is very essential for any economic analysis. This is very crucial for the statistical systems used to collect and present information required by the planners to critically evaluate actions required for plan development. The statistical system developed based on the classifications must enable measuring the contribution of all the economic activities towards the national wealth to facilitate their use for designing the national economic policy and for international comparison. The one such classification used most widely for the purpose of industrial classification is the International Standard Industrial Classification of All Economic Activities ISIC, which is the international reference classification of productive activities. At the national level in India, a similar classification known as the National Industrial Classification NIC was formulated after incorporating the changes required to accommodate national requirement and meeting the requirement of the UN Statistical Commission responsible for the designing of the ISIC. Next is International Standard Industrial Classification ISIC. International Standard Industrial Classification, the background. ISIC adopted for the first time in 1948 mainly aims at providing a set of activity categories that can be utilized for the collection and reporting of statistics according to such activities. ISIC has been used by majority of the countries in the same form as their national activity classification, or it has served as the template for the development of national classifications. It has been used as a tool for providing guidance to the countries on developing their own national classifications and at the same time help them compare statistical data on economic activities at the international level. ISIC has been extensively used at the national as well as international level to classify data in accordance with the kind of economic activities both in the field of economics and social statistics, like statistics on national accounts, demography of enterprises, employment, etc. All the major United Nations bodies and most of the international bodies use ISIC for publishing and analyzing the statistical data. The genesis of ISIC dates back to 1923 when during first International Conference of Labor Statisticians ICLS, International Labour Organization ILO came up with a report which was a compilation of the industrial classification practiced in different countries at that time along with the principles concerning industrial classification. The report recommended that the economic activities to be classified into three broad categories: primary production, agriculture and mining; secondary production, manufacturing and construction; and services, transport, commerce, administration, etc. It was formally adopted in 1948. Over the years, the changes took place in the organization of economic activities and new types of economic activities became important. Thus, there was need for periodic review of the structure and definition of its categories and underlying principles. Statistical Commission, with kind of experience it had with respect to ISIC, during the course of time after its inception, strongly felt that some of the aspects of ISIC should be reviewed, clarified and improved. The commission initiated the reviews and came up with the revisions in 1956, 1965, 1979 and again in 2000. The first, second and the third revision was issued in 1958, 1968 and 1990 respectively, after being considered and approved in the sessions of the Statistical Commission. Next is main features of ISIC. ISIC is based on of internationally agreed concepts, definitions, principles and classification rules. The important features of the ISIC are as follows. First, the framework for the collection of data and its reporting is designed comprehensively for the purposes of economic analysis, decision taking and policy making. The classification structure represents a standard format to organize detailed information about the state of an economy according to economic principles and perceptions. Second, the classification is used to provide continuous flow of information over the period of time. Third, the use of classification is not just restricted to statistics and subsequent economic analysis for providing information about industries, but ISIC is also used for administrative purposes like tax collection, issuance of license, etc. Fourth, ISIC in general covers productive activities or the economic activities that comes within the production boundary of the system of national accounts SNA. For detail, see no more. Fifth, to facilitate easy data collection, presentation and analysis at detailed levels of the economy in an internationally comparable and standardized way. These economic activities are subdivided in a hierarchical four-level structure of mutually exclusive categories. Sixth, the categories at the higher level are called sections, which are alphabetically coded categories intended to facilitate economic analysis. There are 21 sections A to U. Seventh, the sections subdivide the entire spectrum of productive activities into broad groupings, such as agriculture, forestry and fishing in section A, manufacturing section C and information and communication section J. Table shows the detailed sections of ISIC. As you can see, section A shows agriculture, forestry and fishing, B mining and quarrying, C manufacturing, D electricity, gas, steam and air conditioning supply, E water supply, sewerage, waste management and remediation activities, F construction, G wholesale and retail trade, repair of motor vehicles and motorcycles, H transportation and storage, I accommodation and food service activities, J information and communication, K financial and insurance activities, L real estate activities, M professional, scientific and technical activities, N administrative and support service activities, O public administration and defense, compulsory social security, P education, Q human health and social work activities, R arts, entertainment and recreation, S other service activities, T activities of households as employers, undifferentiated goods and services producing activities of households for own use, and last U activities of extraterritorial organizations and bodies. 8th, the classification is then organized into successively more detailed categories which are numerically coded, 2-digit divisions, 3-digit groups and at the greatest level of detail, 4-digit classes. Table shows the classification up to 4-digit classes. Table shows the classification of economic activities, primary production, agriculture, forestry and fishing, secondary production, manufacturing and services, transport, commerce, information and communication, etc. up to 4-digit classes. Table 2 shows ISIC classification of economic activities, 2-digit divisions, 3-digit groups and 4-digit classes. In the following table, you can see column-wise section has been given, then division, then group, then class and lastly description. Note, only 3 major sections representing the primary production, secondary production and services and 2 divisions in each section has been presented in the table to represent ISIC up to 4-digit classes. 9th, The statistical units like establishments or enterprises are classified in accordance with the economic activity in which they are engaged using this classification system. The set of statistical units classified under the same ISIC category are referred as an industry. For example, all statistical units classified in ISIC Division 10, manufacture of food products, would constitute food industry. All units classified in ISIC Division 13, manufacture of textiles, would constitute textile industry or the construction industry, which will refer to all units classified in ISIC Section F, construction. 10th, ISIC serves as an important tool for the socio-economic analysis as well. The socio-economic statistics needs to be arranged in accordance with the productive system of the economy, and ISIC facilitates this by providing complete categorization or subdivision of the complete set of producing units in an economy. Next, the criteria used for delineation of categories. At each level of classification, all the categories are mutually exclusive. The principles and criteria used for delineation of the categories have remained unchanged in most of the revisions and are based on inputs of goods, services and factors of production, process and technology of production, characteristics of outputs, use to which the outputs are put. Each category of the ISIC comprises of the all the economic activities that are similar in respect of this criteria. Process and technology of production has been preferred for to define industrial ISIC classes, the most detailed level of classification, while characteristics of outputs and the use to which outputs are put are the most preferred criteria for grouping of the economic activities at higher level of classification like group, division and section. In addition to the above criteria, other factors that have influenced the categorization includes organization of economic production in most countries and need for stability of the classification. The major practical issue that arises why classification is the overlapping of the boundaries of the two closely related economic activities. Such situation has been sorted out in the ISIC by providing detailed explanatory notes, which provides example of activities that may appear similar but are classified elsewhere in ISIC. The note also provides content and scope of each category in the classification. The classification is applied to a statistical unit by gathering all information on the activity in which the unit engages. The information is then used to find the corresponding category in the ISIC based on the definitions provided in the explanatory notes. Next is National Industrial Classification NIC of India. National Industrial Classification NIC of India background. India has a long history of industrial classification. It has been widely used in the population census, enterprise surveys, labor statistics, national income estimation, etc. In the early years, organizations responsible for collection of statistical data used wide variety of industrial classification. This led to the urgent requirement of having a common industrial classification in India that could be used by different agencies. The Central Statistical Organization CSO took up the task of evolving a national industrial classification in early 1960. Based on the suggestions it received from various concerned agencies of the Government of India, such as the Registrar General, Economic Advisors to the Ministries of Finance, Food and Agriculture, Commerce and Industry, Indian Bureau of Mines, National Employment Service, Labour Bureau, Planning Commission, National Sample Survey and Indian Statistical Institute, etc., and keeping in view the requirements, the CSO came with a draft National Industrial Classification called Standard Industrial Classification SIC, which was finalized and released in 1962. The SIC was four-digit classification and consisted of 9 divisions, 55 major groups, 284 groups and 753 subgroups. ISIC revision 1 was followed in its entirety at the division 1 digit level with slight deviations at the major group 2 digit level. SIC retains all the groups of the ISIC at the group 3 digit level. In addition, it provides some more groups keeping in view the special features of the Indian economy. While the ISIC stops at the group level, the SIC moves a step ahead by including a lower level of classification in terms of subgroups, 4-digit level, so as to meet the national requirements adequately. This classification was based on ISIC Revision 1, 1958. It was revised subsequently and released in the form of National Industrial Classification, NIC. NIC 1970 and NIC 1987 brought out were based on ISIC Revised 2, 1968, NIC 1998 and NIC 2004 on ISIC Revision 3, 1990 and ISIC Revision 3.1, 2002 respectively. All these revisions updating were done to include the changes in the ISIC as well as the changes in the structure of Indian industries. As the NIC is based on ISIC, so the basic features and the criteria for delineation almost remain the same except for the time to time revisions that were made in the past based on the revisions in ISIC. Next is major revisions of National Industrial Classification, NIC. National Industrial Classification, NIC 1970, the first revision. Based on the ISIC Revision 2, the SIC 62 was revised in 1970 and was now known as National Industrial Classification, NIC 1970. A 1-to-1 match was retained at 1-digit and 2-digit levels. All the 3-digit categories were made equivalent to 2. All the international classification categories up to 4-digit level, that is NIC 3-digit structure, included all the 4-digit classification of ISIC. The main objective of NIC 1970 was to meet the national requirements of various user organizations. Following changes were inducted in the NIC 1970 as compared to SIC 62. It differed from the previous version in having two special divisions, Division 1 for activities not adequately defined and Division Y for personal and repair services. It also included 64 major groups, 383 groups and 590 subgroups as compared to 9 divisions, 55 major groups, 284 groups and 753 subgroups of SIC 62. In NIC 1970, for classification of enterprises type classification did not extend beyond the 3rd digit level. The 4th digit extension in NIC 1970 was made mainly to meet the requirement for more details in classifying establishment. Repair services was brought under manufacturing instead of household and personal services as was in ISIC. NIC 1970, however, does provide flexibility of including repair services either in Division 3 manufacturing or under Division 9 as per the convenience and requirement of users. Next, National Industrial Classification, NIC 1987, the second revision. The second revision of the NIC took place in 1987. During the second revision, NIC 1970 was revised in 1987 based on the ISIC Revision 2 of 1968, as there has been no corresponding revision in ISIC since the Revision 2 of 1968. The following changes were made in NIC 1987 as compared to NIC 1970. No changes were imposed at the 1-digit level and the economy remained divided into 9 sections and the special section X, activities not adequately defined. The special division Y was dropped in this revision as the activities relating to repair services had been placed only at Division 97 of NIC 1987 as compared to NIC 1970, which had it in 2 places, viz. Division Y and 9 major group 97. 2-digit level was expanded by 8 divisions, bringing it to 72 divisions as against 64 in NIC 1970. Of the 8 additional 2-digit codes, 3 were in mining and quarrying section, with one each in manufacturing, repair of capital goods and electricity generation of non-conventional energy sections. Three in the section relating to finance, insurance, real estate and business services. The three-digit level categories were also increased to meet the requirement of more detailed activities which had become important in the intervening period. The most drastic change that took place in this revision was the appearance of four-digit classification throughout NIC 1987. In NIC 1970, it was restricted to sections dealing with mining and manufacturing. The four-digit classification was mainly introduced to differentiate the scale and or technologies of operation and also to take into account the product specialization. There was an expansion at the three-digit level, making a total of 461 as compared to 383 in NIC 1970. The number of four-digit level categories in NIC 1987 was 918 as against 590 in NIC 1970. Next, National Industrial Classification NIC 1998, the third revision. The third revision of NIC was brought about in 1998 as NIC 1998. The main focus of the revision was to take into consideration the changes of economic activities enforced by technological evolution since 1987 and most importantly to capture the activities related to service industry. The revision followed in totality the ISIC Revision 3 1990 codes up to 4-digit level. This was then extended to 5-digit coding system in order to accumulate all major NIC 1987 codes and also to meet national requirements to cover the emerging activities and do away with the obsolete activities. The classification does not make any distinction based on the kind of ownership, type of legal organization, type of technology and scale mode of operation. All units engaged in similar activity are classified in the same category of the NIC irrespective of the type of ownership, incorporated enterprises, individual proprietor or government owned, and if the enterprise has more than one establishment, the other key features included. Introduction of a new group, growing of crops combined with farming of animals, mixed farming relating to agriculture, hunting and forestry. Addition of a new division on recycling in manufacturing section. Addition of a separate division for all activities related to motor vehicles and motorcycles and retail sale of automotive fuel in section relating to wholesale and retail trade, repair of motor vehicles, motorcycles and personal and household goods, etc. All activities carried out by government units that are specifically attributable to other areas of classification were classified in the appropriate class of NIC and not in Division 75, Public Administration and Defense, Compulsory Social Security. A new Division 72 has been created to include the complete range for all computer related activities. A new Division 71 relating to renting of machinery and equipment without operator and of personal and household goods included all renting and leasing activities regardless of goods rented or leased. 2. Concordance table was prepared to facilitate convertibility with earlier version NIC 1987, a concordance table between 4-digit level of NIC 98 and 3-digit level of NIC 87 for translating NIC 87 based data in terms of the 4-digit classes of NIC 98 and the other between 2-digit level of NIC 87 and appropriate level of NIC 1998 for the conversion of the NIC 98 base data in terms of 2-digit codes of NIC 87. Next, National Industrial Classification NIC 2004, the fourth revision. The United Nations Statistics Division UNSD updated the ISIC Revision 3 and released ISIC Revision 3.1. To maintain the consistency with the classification of economic activities released by UNSD and meet the national requirements on account of changes in the structure of economy, as many new activities have come in existence while some of the old activities have either disappeared or become insignificant, NIC 1988 was updated to NIC 2004. The whole exercise did not involve any major changes in the existing classification of NIC 98 except for removing ambiguity, duplications, omissions, etc. by suitably modifying the explanatory notes. Some of the key features of NIC 2004 are as follows. In NIC 2004, sections A to Q replaced the tabulation categories A to Q of NIC 98. NIC 2004 has 17 sections, 62 divisions, 161 groups, 310 classes and 1191 subclasses. NIC 2004 is comparable in totality with ISIC revision 3.1 up to 4 digit level. All the changes reflected in ISIC revision 3.1, including creation of new classes and divisions, have been incorporated in updated NIC 2004. Suggestions of the user organizations have been accommodated by creating shadow 4-digited classes under the respective groups, as against 1021 5-digit subclasses in NIC 98. The updated NIC 2004 had total 1191 subclasses. This was due to incorporation of the suggestions of the users for changes at 5-digit subclass level to meet the national requirement and to maintain the compatibility with ISIC revision 3.1 up to 4-digit level except shadow classes. Next, National Industrial Classification NIC 2008, the 5th revision. NIC 2004 has been revised to NIC 2008. This has been done keeping in view the recommendations of that 38th session of the UN Statistical Commission, which required countries to either adopt ISIC revision 4 or to make changes in their national classification such that their data are presentable according to the categories of the ISIC revision 4. The commission required the national classification to be fully compatible with the 2-digit division level of the ISIC. India adopted the ISIC revision 4 and used it as a basis for revision of NIC 2004 to NIC 2008. The revised NIC 2008 provides a more contemporary industrial classification system. The revision has taken into account the changes in structure and composition of the economy, changing user requirements and comparability with international standards. The structural difference between NIC 2004 based on ISIC revision 3.1 and NIC 2008 based on ISIC revision 4 is in grouping of activities, which is mainly based on the relevance. The structure of NIC 2008 is identical to the structure of ISIC revision 4 up to 4-digit level class. The major difference in the further division of classes into 5-digit subclasses according to national requirements. Activities are first grouped into section alphabetically coded from A through U. Every section is divided into division with 2-digit numeric code, every division into group with 3-digit numeric code, every group into class with 4-digit numeric code, and every 4-digit class into 5-digit subclass. Table provides an illustration of the 5-digit classification in NIC 2008. Table shows NIC 2008 classification of economic activities. 2-digit divisions, 3-digit groups, 4-digit classes and 5-digit subclasses. As you can see in the table, section, then division, then group, then class, then subclass, then description has been given column-wise. Note, section C, manufacturing, is given to illustrate the structure. NIC 2008 differs from the ISIC in division of classes into 5-digit subclasses according to national requirements. Next, some of the important features of NIC 2008 are as follows. In NIC 2008, sections A to U replaces the sections A to Q of NIC 2004. NIC 2008 has 21 sections, 88 divisions, 238 groups, 403 classes and 1304 subclasses. NIC 2008 is comparable with ISIC revision 4 till 4-digit classes in totality. As NIC 2008 emphasizes more on activity rather than type of operation and scale of operation, the concept of shadow classes introduced in NIC 2004 is no longer part of the classification. To facilitate better understanding of the revised classification, explanatory notes of ISIC revised 4 at 1/2/3 digit level has been incorporated in NIC 2008 as annexure. Inclusion and exclusion statements have been included in the detailed structure itself to do away with any ambiguity in the scope of classification and make the classification of economic activity more distinct. Now let us summarize what we have discussed in this module. International Standard Industrial Classification of All Economic Activities ISIC, adopted for the first time in 1948, mainly aims at providing a set of activity categories that can be utilized for the collection and reporting of statistics according to such activities. ISIC, used by majority of the countries in the same form as their national activity classification, or it has served as the template for the development of national classifications. ISIC provides a framework for the collection of data and its reporting, which is designed comprehensively for the purposes of making analysis, decision taking and policy making. The structure of ISIC comprises of the alphabetically coded 21 sections, A to U, 2-digit divisions, 3-digit groups and at the greatest level of detail, 4-digit classes. Classification of all the categories are mutually exclusive. Delineation of the categories to avoid overlaps of similar economic activities is based on input of goods, services and factors of production, process and technology of production, characteristics of output and use to which the outputs are put. Standard Industrial Classification SIC released in 1962 was India's first classification, which was later modified in 1970 based on the ISIC revision to 1968 as National Industrial Classification NIC 1970. Till date, NIC has undergone 5 revisions. NIC 1970, NIC 1987, NIC 1998, NIC 2004 and NIC 2008. Each of these revisions is based on the latest ISIC revisions enforced during the course of time and has been done to meet the national interest. The fifth revision, NIC 2008, is identical to the structure of ISIC revised 4 up to 4-digit level class and differs mainly in the further section of classes into 5-digit subclasses according to national requirements. In NIC 2008 has 21 sections A to U, 88 divisions, 238 groups, 403 classes and 1304 subclasses.